When you buy property in Hawaii, the structures don't always have building permits. What does that mean? How do you find out? Everything about building permits is coming up next. Hey, what's going on, friends? Dylan Nonaka here from Coldwell Banker Island Properties now. Brand new company, made the announcement last week, but it's official now. So we are now Coldwell Banker Island Properties. And this week we're gonna be talking about building permits and everything that you need to know about them. So first thing is, when you buy a property or you're gonna build something, make sure you get building permits, because there's a bunch of implications if you don't. And if you're gonna buy a property, you definitely wanna check on the status of building permits, and does a property have them? And if they don't, what are the implications due to that? And sometimes they do have them, but they're not closed. So we're gonna talk a little bit about that. So the first thing is how do you check? It's pretty easy to do. You go to the county building department, that information is online. We can check very easily through the MLS. You can access it through a public site. It's a little bit harder to find through the public site because you gotta know how to type in the tax map keys. But if you ask us, ask a realtor, we can find out real easily and check for you what the status of building permits are. And you definitely wanna do that before you move forward with making an offer on a property, because there can be issues that it's gonna affect the loan and the appraisal and different things like that. So the records may not always be accurate either, because, you know, properties may have been built on 30, 40, 50 years ago and county records weren't digitized at the time. Sometimes you actually gotta go down there and dig through the records and find and see what they have. So a couple of different things that you need to do. Sometimes it's quick and easy. You look, all the building permits are there and everything's fine. If it's not, then you wanna be working with somebody who knows what they're doing in order to find out the information that you need to properly evaluate the property's building permit status. So how does this normally happen in terms of building permits either not being pulled or they're not being closed? And basically two ways, right? A builder just builds something, they add an addition on, or sometimes they build the whole entire home without building permits and there's no record of the home actually being there. It may not have been built to code, and in reality, it doesn't have any real value in terms of an appraisal, and so it causes a problem if you're trying to get a loan on a property. The second way you have building permit issues is that contractors or sometimes homeowners go in and they actually do pull building permits. They build something, they put an addition on, and they don't get the final inspections done in order to close the building permit out. And this happens a lot with like solar, where they pull electrical or plumbing permits. The solar company comes, puts the solar panels, especially with hot water, solar hot water panels on the property, installs everything, everything's good to go. They go on their merry way. 5 years later, you try and sell the house and you find out there's an open plumbing permit because the contractor that put your solar on never actually closed the permit. So you wanna make sure you're checking on that and finding out if all of that was done, because it can cause an issue for a buyer who's evaluating the property if you are trying to sell. So some common issues that we see over and over and over again is definitely the simple one of where building permits were pulled, but they were never closed. And then we have to deal with that, going through the county, sometimes ordering an inspection and getting that final inspection done in order to close a building permit that was pulled, construction was done properly, and the inspections were never done. A lot of times, what happens is homeowners maybe bought a property 10, 15, 20 years ago, never checked on this, wasn't as big of a deal back then, and then now they're trying to sell and they find out there's open permits from when the house was constructed 10 years before they even bought it. And that becomes your issue now if you're the homeowner and you have to go through the process of getting those permits closed. And that can be difficult, but it can be done. And that's a common issue that comes up also, where you think everything's good, you bought the house, everything's been fine, and then you find out that the previous owner or the person that built the house didn't go through the permitting process completely, and now you're stuck with that issue and you have to deal with it before you can sell. So you definitely want to check on it because of that. Then there's other issues where no permits were pulled, right? So maybe the original house was built where with permits and then they added an addition or added a bedroom on and didn't use permits, and then there's a discrepancy in the square footage between what is in the county records and what is actually on the ground on the property. So you wanna make sure that that also is taken care of and that issue is dealt with if you run into that. There's another issue where people actually pull permits to do an addition or a change or build something on a property, and then they never actually do it. And so the property, especially with vacant land, you know, you put vacant land up for sale and then you go and look at the county records and there's building permits that were pulled to build something on it, but there's nothing actually on the land. And you're gonna wanna get those closed out prior to trying to sell or buy that piece of property, so you don't have to deal with those permits and any implications that that may cause in the future. So you want to check on that also, where you think it's a vacant piece of property, but there are building permits on the property, which will prohibit you from getting additional building permits until those are dealt with. So you want to make sure you figure that out, especially if you're in the buying process and you plan to build. You want to get that current owner or that previous owner to take care of that prior to you taking ownership. Because there's two big negative effects to having unpermitted structures on your property. The first one being an appraisal. So a lot of times people will build unpermitted stuff, and when an appraiser comes in to appraise that property for the loan that you're trying to get, they're not going to count that additional space, additional square footage towards the value of the home. So you have a discrepancy between what the seller thinks the house is worth because they have all this additional room, and then what an appraiser is going to look at, because the appraiser is going to look at the actual permitted square footage of the home when they do an appraisal. And then it can also cause an issue with financing, especially like VA financing, because a VA appraiser is going to come in, and if there's unpermitted space or structures on a property, they're going to be concerned about, was it built to code? Is it safe? And it can definitely cause a problem getting that loan approved. And so you want to make sure you do with that, or you evaluate that before you get too far along in the process. Because once you order an appraisal as a buyer, you know, that can cost you $500, $600, $700, and you're going to be out that money if the appraiser doesn't say that the property qualifies to close your loan. So lots of different issues in the building permit world. You definitely want to be working with somebody who is familiar with it and can help you solve those issues. A lot of times, as realtors, that's what we do, is we solve problems because we're familiar with them. We know who to call. We know the process. We've been through it before. And so ask us. You know, if you're not sure, or you're going to put your property on the market, you definitely want the realtor that you're working with to ask you these questions or to do this evaluation up front, because you never want to put a property on the market that has a bunch of issues, especially permitting issues, which is going to prevent a sale or greatly restrict the type of buyer that's going to buy it, because it may be a cash only sale due to the fact that the house isn't fully permitted, or there are permits that are open and need to be closed, and there can be some costs there, especially with like a pool. We've dealt with issues where pools are built, they've been there for 15 years, and you find out that the pool permit was never closed, and to retroactively close a pool permit can be pretty arduous, and there can be some cost involved with getting an architect to go in and redesign plans and getting people to go and ensure that the electrical and the plumbing is all done right. So lots of different issues that permits can cause in the buying and selling process, and you want to make sure that you're evaluating that up front. And as always, you can always give us a call and we can take a look your property up real quick, give you an idea of what's going on, and we can go from there. But as always, ask questions in the comments if you got any. You can always hit me up at Dylan@buybigisland.com. And thank you guys for watching. It's a beautiful day in Kona. It has been for weeks now without the fog. And so it's a great time to visit or buy and just go to the beach. So I'll see you guys next week. Aloha.